Now's the time, Portal Master.
Hey everyone, welcome back. This is Mike with SkylanderNutts.com, and today I'm going to be walking you through Chapter 5 of Skylanders Imaginators. Now, I believe this one was called the Sky Fortress. We're going to be helping Jetpack out. We're going to be getting onto the big airship, and I'll help you find all of the stars for this chapter, as well as show you how to beat the Guacamole Monster, which isn't that hard, but the boys did have a slight problem with it at first. So let me get into the game. Today I'm going to be using Airstrike. He's going to be my featured Skylander of the day. And let's get into the game. Now Airstrike is a brawler Skylander. So he is going to be doing lots of hand-to-hand combat. But he's got this little bird that helps him out. This falcon. You can see it when I do an attack, the falcon kind of does a little cutting motion, like a slicing motion. So not only do you get an up-close attack with the fist of Airstrike here, you get the little wing attack bonus. So it's kind of like a double melee. It's kind of cool. Oh, let me go get this rat hole real quick.
One of these holes leads to the secret rat kingdom.
That's right. One of these days, I might get to the secret rat kingdom.
And of course, rats.
But not today. We got to go down a few more holes before that happens. All right. So let's go talk to Mags here and jump up into the Sky Fortress, I think.
So here's my Sheep Flash Skylander launcher. Now you just hold your heel still here, buddy, while I give you a good fling. In a frying pan! Yeah!
Our battleship is just inside that hangar, Skylander. So are a bunch of vultures. Let's go and change all that.
Alright, so there's the Sky Fortress level, but let's check out this new area of the map first. If we come up here to the right, we're going to find the Air Sensei Realm.
Sensei Air Realm discovered.
That's not too bad. We got a lock here, but that's actually for fighting the Guacamole Monster. It's not a real level, we found out, but you can quit after you get all your stars for the Sky Fortress level, and then come back, and you'd come back here to get onto the battleship. But here is a little bomb thing, so we're gonna take that, jump down here where we find the Dark Sensei Realm.
Sensei Dark Realm discovered.
But we're gonna skip that for now, and whoa, put it down and break open that door. That was a little fast. That was a fast fuse, I think because I discovered the Dark Realm. Clear out some of these weak enemies in here, get some bonus experience, some money, and we have an Imaginite chest. Epic this time.
New arm guards.
Oh, Brave Bones armor. That looks kind of cool. Oh, yeah. Alright, so that was our little cave from the bomb. And then if we fall off, look, there's a little arrow here. We fall off one more time. And we find a book. I think there's four books, I'm not sure. But we can bring that back to the academy here in a little while and get some more Imaginite chests for that. So now we just have to drop all the way back down and ride the elevator back up again. That's pretty much it for that section of the map. Not too much on this side, but two Sensei Realms.
Just inside that hangar, Skylander.
You might forget they're here sometimes, too.
Let's go and change all that.
Alright, so let's get into the Sky Fortress now.
Sky Fortress.
take a look at our goals. We got our typical story goals. We're going to have three treasure chests to find, one legendary selfie frame, which again is a little tricky on this level, three soul gems, and one troll radio. Plus we'll do the gong, and hopefully we'll get no lives lost. Though Airstrike is kind of, he's pretty high level now, but I had some problems with him early on, surviving that long, because he is a brawler. Most times I find brawlers take a little bit more damage and get you in trouble, because they got to get right up and close with the action.
Nature's cruelest mistake. Sucks to be you. These scavenger creeps have completely taken over our battleship. And according to intel reports, eaten most of my lunch from the galley's mini fridge. So, I'll scout up ahead, enveloping the enemy in a classic pincer movement. Plus, maybe I can find the guy who stole my food and make him pay. Use this station to build a robot helper. That's what my mother always told me, and it seems like good advice here.
All right. So here we are at the Sky Fortress.
Tech Skylanders are stronger here.
Yeah, tech Skylanders are stronger here, but I'm ignoring that for now, just so I can use Airstrike for a while. It's not too hard of an area to need a tech Skylander. Now, Airstrike's got this interesting secondary attack where he drops these feathers, and if they run into the feathers, they get attacked. Plus, a little bird comes, the falcon comes down and slams the ground nearby. It's a pretty effective attack. I like to use a lot, especially when there's lots of creatures around. Alright, let's push this button.
How are you? Looks like a vulture battleship is heading our way. Let's build an anti-vulture. I call it the vulture.
Alright, we'll use this little rocket thing they just created.
Hit the big metal bird.
Destroy the vulture ship.
3, 2, 1.
Woohoo! Bombs away!
Look at that. That was pretty easy. I don't know if you have to do that. I can't remember if the boys did that or not. Seems like you could skip it if you wanted. You might not find that legendary selfie frame if you did. Of course, that's not important to get you 3 stars. Just a little bonus point. Look at my feathers crush all these guys. I use this attack a lot as well to get away from the enemies. So I come in there with my typical melee attacks. But then when I get too crowded, I'll run away. And these feathers will do damage and allow me to reset, because he runs a little bit faster when he's using that move. There we go.
Hey, over here!
Selfie!
Watch your step here, Skylander.
Alright, now these planks, they're not too hard. But you have to remember that if you stay too long on one side, the other side raises up. You want to pause and let it raise up so you can actually jump off of it and onto the next ledge. Sometimes they put that next level kind of high. And we'll see in a little bit. There's some trickier jumps we will have to make. There's one of our treasure chests. We'll get that in a second. Take care of these guys first. Oh, these guys are tough. Whoa, I just got hit by him. Not tough in, as far as they're hard to beat, but man, they deal a lot of damage with that wrecking ball. Gotta be careful with this guy.
Only a sensei of the Smasher class can open this shrine.
Alright, so much here. right here, you know. First, let's get this chest all the way to the right once you drop down. Our first treasure chest. Woo-hoo! Now we have the, what is that, the Smasher Sensei realm. So let me quickly switch to one of the Smashers here. Of course, I've already unlocked the Sky Chi move for the Smasher, but let's watch the video.
Can't stop the chop.
You can also see the treasure chest in her video, even though I already got it. It's there. It gives you a little hint that it's nearby.
Sky Chi power ready.
Here we go. Alright, back to air strike. There's some upgrades for air strike. Give you some, I think they're combo powers and everything. So when I punch once, it just does damage. But if I do it three times, you'll notice those little tornado or air, you know, little whirlwinds get launched. That's based on the upgrade. Your imaginary chest, I think, for beating all those enemies we just fought.
New tail.
Oh, a tail. Interesting. Woohoo! All right. And you can see we also get an experience ball. There's a couple of those on this level. So whatever Skylander you bring, you can earn some decent experience just from finding those. Alright, no one's attacking me.
Fire Skylanders are stronger here.
Alright, now the Fire Skylanders are stronger. We should kick off some story here. There we go.
Heads up, Skylander. A Vulture cargo ship is headed right this way. See, there it is. And it's loaded with supplies for an upcoming invasion. Or maybe the Vulture's annual chili cook-off. Either way, I say we smash those crates with a wrecking ball. You just need to restore power to the wrecking ball first.
All right, so we're gonna go restore that power. Pick up these coins from these barrels. Now, this is a little block puzzle, but it's not very hard, really. You can't walk through or jump past the beams. So you're going to have to move these blocks into spots like that. So this beam now is contained in that area. If we want to get through there, which we don't really have to do, we're going to have to put a block in there somehow. Basically, wherever you can go, I guess just go. We can move this block down. Oh, I thought I could move that over. Guess not. Cross over to this side. There's a block we can move. I guess that's good enough. We don't really have to push him in a lot of strange configurations. All we really need to do is get up here to the controls. Let's see. There's one more block somewhere I can move. Oh, there it is. I move it all the way up. So it blocks into the, that's why we knocked this block down, so we could contain that beam. And now we can move this block over to contain the other beam. There we go. Now we can get to this little platform to jump up.
Dynamite!
Here we have our second treasure chest up here. And then we didn't see it from below, but if we walk down the other side, we're gonna find a soul gem. There it is.
Knight soul gem.
It's our Knight Imaginator soul gem. Let's preview the knight.
Knight Imaginator is a brave woman, highly trained in the noble art of swordplay.
All right, and that's it for in here, so we can now open or activate the wrecking ball.
Capital. Now see this control panel out here. Come and use it to start wrecking.
The wrecking ball is kind of fun. Get our selfie frame over here in the corner. And some extra cash. Squawk and all. Pretty dangerous looking vulture. Alright, so we have this little battle now. Again, I'm going to use the secondary attack a lot to run. We can also get Jetback to do a little bombing run there. That'll help add some damage. Whoops. I ran right into the building. That's not what I wanted to do. Now, notice how Jetback has moved sides.
Nothing like a good bombing run.
There's Hawk and All's main attack. He kind of dashes after you. After which, he'll be stunned for a couple seconds, so you can do some damage right then. Melee attack and then run around with some feathers. Now he also has his third attack. I just used it there for a second. If you hit the Y button on the Xbox One or your attack 3, it'll be a little all directions melee berserk kind of mode, I guess. We can pick up our Imaginite chest.
New bazooka weapon.
Ooh, two bazooka. Alright, now here's the easy thing to miss. You might just want to go straight to the crane, but don't do that. The Hawk and All just came out of this door over here. We can actually now go into this room. And we're going to find all kinds of stuff in here.
Are stronger here.
The only thing that's important for the three stars, though, is the control radio, but we can also play the egg game, so we can do that. Egg rescue. Start by just destroying all these blocks that you can, then try to take out one egg. There is already unlocked. I try taking out the guys as much as possible. Oh, they threw some good chunks at that egg, so let's get rid of him. And three eggs rescued. Not too hard. I think concentrate on the eggs without a force field first. I believe that force field may protect the egg from even the bad guys. So once you destroy the force field to actually pick up the egg, and don't let it sit there for too long. There's our troll radio. We got an Imaginite chest added to our vault. And then here we get a little snail Imaginite chest chase. Ooh, an ultimate.
New leg guards.
Alright. Ultimates have the best stats, 40 speed, 15 armor, sounds pretty cool. And we have a Skystones battle, Creation Clash, but we're not going to do that today. All the Creation Clash games are kind of the same, even though you have different tiles. The strategy is the same for all of them. And since they give you the tiles each match, you kind of always have, I don't want to say an advantage, but the same chance of winning, I guess. You don't have to build your own deck and do all that stuff like you did before, so you don't run the risk of fighting an opponent that's too tough. It's just a set of tiles, and it should be, you know, comparable to the enemy's set of tiles, so it should be a fairly close match every time. All right, let's get into this.
This way, Skylander.
Wrecking ball now and play this little mini game.
You're now in control of your very own wrecking ball. Use it wisely, my friend. More specifically, use it to knock the explosive crates overboard as quickly as you can. This wrecking ball moves forward and backward for swinging, side to side for aiming, but not back in time.
All right, so I like just moving the wrecking ball like by pressing up and down. You can see the red aimer thing move. If you don't move it too fast, the wrecking ball is going to go, you know, kind of in a straight line. So we try to do that back and forth.
Excellent work, Skylar.
Up and back.
Good job knocking off those crates. But uh-oh, here comes some more enemies with more explosives. Might as well knock them off too, right? Preferably before they can get those explosives to the opposite platform.
Alright, we keep the same sort of motion, just back and forth. And then slowly move it left and right, and we can knock these guys off as they come. If you don't press up and down as much, the wrecking ball will lose momentum and won't really swing anymore. You don't really want that. Oh, I missed him. Don't be afraid to miss him. You miss him a couple times, you'll get him on the next swing, usually. As long as you put the red circle on him, you're gonna probably hit him. If you're going back and forth, you will. If you're going too much left to right, you might miss. You might end up doing like circles. Go. Now the boys played this on expert. No, I'm only playing on normal. And I think they had a they moved faster, I think, across the ship. Gave some problems. Now before we go over fight these guys, jump over here to the right and get the second soul gem.
Starcast soul gem.
We'll preview Starcast. Sure, he's pretty cool.
Starcast.
Alright. Now we gotta get ready for a little battle. Another little battle. Feathers do the damage. Look at that. Wow. Feather attack really destroyed them there. Pick up all this extra experience. And here's some more of those tilting platforms. So we just let it tilt for a second and then run across and jump.
No idea why we made these platforms so hard to jump on. Skylanders, this way.
All right, he wants us to go right. We're gonna go left so we can find the other sensei shrine. Of course, there's a wrecking ball creature in the box. You'll see that a few times on this level. Now Airstrike's just getting powerful because he can take him out in only a few shots, a few of those attacks. When he's lower level, that's a much harder battle against that guy. Alright, Quick Shot Shrine. So let's put on Dr. Crankcase and check out his video. So there's Dr. Crankcase's Sky Chi power. And Tide Pool isn't out yet, so when she comes out, I'll have to replay this level and get her to the shrine. Alright. Strike is up to 780 health. That's pretty good.
Capital! You've made it to the main hangar. And more importantly, dun dun dun! The battleship! Somewhere on this glorious vessel is my lunch. And a whole lot more vultures. Let's find a way to get on board and take back control of the ship.
Senseis are stronger here.
Alright, now all senseis are stronger, so I'll be doing some bonus damage here. I think this is a selfie spot? Nope. They do like to hide those selfie spots, though. There we go, we fall down and I fell right onto the experience ball. That's the only thing down here. Hit the button to activate the elevator. Now this is where the boys kind of have a problem with jumping. You can wait just off center and then run when you want to. So you don't have to run across it. You won't fall off if you stay toward the center. And if you stay on the one side of the center, the other side will stay up. So that'll give you time to make your jump. And you always want to jump toward the upside, because as you run toward it, it'll start to go down. And then you can make your jump. Alright, before you go to the next jump, you gotta come up here, destroy these crates, and you'll find this lever. So now you can pull the lever, and another set of these jumps appears, and these are much harder. This is where you gotta use your skills and weight, because here comes another one. They all move. Be patient at the center until you know where the next platform's coming from.
Dynamite.
There you go. Oh, one more. There's our third soul gem. That one's kind of tricky.
Blastertron.
Yes, let's preview.
Blastertron.
All right, and instead of having to jump all the way back, They give you a nice little warp portal here. That's pretty nice of them. There you go. Straight back to where you were. Now you can continue down the normal path.
You punks are looking for a fight, you sure found one. Water Skylanders are stronger here.
Uh-oh. Kind of ran into that one, but he also got lucky where he got blocked.
Those guys look pretty tough.
Every once in a while when you get hit, your shield activates and you don't take as much or zero damage.
First thing we need to do to get the ship running again is to turn the engine on. Makes sense, right? And that all starts with moving these blocks into position so that they can power up the turbines. Then you'll want to flip the circuit breakers and the ship should be in ship shape. Try saying that 5 times fast. Tech Skylanders are stronger here.
All right, so move these blocks to the as far as they go, all the way that way, and then all the way this way. Gonna put them all in this line right here. Some baby vultures, which are as easy as chompies.
See if you can move those blocks into a line.
And the blocks, just, it's not very hard to move. You move that one out of the way, then over, then up for some reason. And this one can go back into the first spot. All you gotta do is push that last one off and you're done.
Perfect. Now onto
the
circuit breakers.
Now the platforms rotate. It doesn't matter which side you go to first. Just pull the lever.
I'm no mathematician, but that just leaves one more to go.
Then go to the other side. Pull the lever.
Excellent work, Skylander. Now, back on deck. This way.
Alright. But before you leave, you just activated those spinning, I don't know what they are, cranks there in the background. But if you can notice at the top right part of the screen, there's an imaginary chest up on that ledge. So we're going to try to make the jumps over to get that chest. I mean, to come in here to get the food, and then waiting, and then jumping all the way across. You jump, whoa, too eager. I needed to wait one more second. Nope. See, I like to get on top of the last one that spins there. That makes it a little easier. You probably can jump all the way across if you're fast enough, but I'm usually not. So wait, and on this side of it, oh, I fell off again. Crazy. It's not the easiest set of jumps in the world, but it's also not that hard. I just keep screwing it up. It's a little more than just jump. You gotta jump, walk, jump. There we go. Or double jump. There's our Imaginite chest. Now you don't have to do that. That's not part of the 3 stars, but it is a small little secret for the level. And then of course portal, so you don't have to do that again. Alright, so now we can jump on this button and follow Jetback out.
So if we're going to actually fly the ship again, we'll want to unchain it from the hangar. And if we want to unchain it from the hangar, just unscrew the pin on this clamp and hope that we don't accidentally break anything.
Alright, so we're getting ready to unscrew the pin. You can see the treasure chest behind Jetpack moving around, so we know our last treasure chest is nearby.
Hey, it worked! And nothing seems broken! Bonus!
Here's the button. Go ahead and get up there now. Alright, there we go, last treasure. Now we got a little battle.
Come on, put up your dukes.
Level up.
Blast! The hangar doors are locked, which will make getting the ship out of here a little tricky. But I might just have a way to get them open. It's not exactly by the book, but desperate guacamole monster times call for desperate measures.
All right, so we get an imaginite chest for beating all those guys. Plus, I leveled up, which is just good for me, extra power.
New chest. Set part.
Set part. One more to go. Let's see. Airstrike has enough money, but I don't know
these
if I have a soul gem.
Can't measure what's really inside.
Nope.
A guy.
Oh yeah, because we haven't played the bonus level that came with his pack. So.
Light Skylanders are stronger here.
So what you need to do, C, is load these turret shells into the main gun. That's how we're gonna get the doors open. Told you it wasn't by the book.
All right. Got a lot of leftover experience floating around. We're gonna load these into the gun. I guess they're basically torpedoes or bullets. They look like fans, but. Or engines, even. Really not that. Oops. It's not that hard of a push puzzle. Just kind of busy work.
Now, pop the next shell in, and we should just about be ready for some blasting.
Grab some extra treasure. Which I guess I technically don't need anymore, because I have enough for the soul gem move. Once I unlock it. We go.
Now just come out on deck and observe the fruits of your labor. Cover your ears, Skylander, if you have it. Well,
all right.
That worked quite nicely, didn't it? Now we just need to remove all the clamps before this ship is ready to set sail again.
So we got more clamps to remove, and our ship will be ready to escape.
Come on, Birdie. Let's make an entrance. We'll take on all comers, if you will.
All right, so now we got another little mini battle full with Jetpack's help. Get a bombing run in there. Well, feathers. Bird slam. Take out some more. Jet back in again. Oh, there's a bunch of experience there.
How about that, Birdie? All our training really paid off.
Skylander, this way.
All right, now I guess we should get our Imaginite chest. But we don't want to unclamp that yet.
New arms.
Oh, some basic arms. Oh, of the diver set.
Oh, yeah.
All right, before we go any further, first notice there's a hamburger floating up there. And then notice these two buttons. So if we hit these buttons one after the other and jump on them real quick because they go away, jump down that.
Undead Skylanders are stronger here.
I think this is the trickiest one to find. Tricky that you would jump in that tube, and then if we get all the way across it, we'll get our legendary selfie frame, which is our reward for all this. Activate the lever. Activate the next lever. Now watch this one spin and rotate. Oh, I missed. It's kind of tricky to get on. It's even tricky to stay on, kind of. Now if you want the bonus treasure, you're going to have to time it right to get off on that side. I missed the time there. Here we go. That's one. Now we got to time it to get off all the way on the other side. I screwed up already. Now I got to go toward the side that's up, so the same side is always going to be up, which is not the side I'm on. So, come this way. There. Get it ready. And then, as it gets closer, I'm going to start running. There we go. Legendary selfie frame. And I do think that's everything. We can check real quick. Yep. All treasure chests, selfie frame, soul gem, and troll radio. Still have to do the gong. That's coming up in a second. And have not died, so that's good. And brings us right back out where we were.
Ah, just another obstacle on our way to the title.
Almost got them. Just one more.
There's a button here, but that's for continuing the level. We don't want to do that. We want to come this way. First, we have to unclamp this.
Doors blown open, clamps removed. I suppose all that's left to do now is head to the bridge and fly this ship out of here.
Yeah, the bridge is up that way.
It goes without saying that I would still very much like to find my lunch at some point too.
But if we want that gong battle, we gotta come this way first.
Strike the battle gong.
There's the gong.
Senseis are stronger here.
And a selfie frame spot. All right. So let's bang the gong and take on all comers. This will be pretty easy, though.
Ring-a-ding-ding.
We'll let these small guys get in, some big guys coming up. Oh, they can't go out that way. Now I'm getting surrounded. I'm going to unleash my Sky Chi. And just dash around on this air wing bird.
Who wants some more of that, huh?
And I won't kill everybody, but I killed a lot of them. Back to the feathers. Get trapped, hit my Y button, battle everything that's nearby. That's it.
Those guys looked pretty tough, but they got no heart.
I like gong battles. You get a ton of money and experience from them. And of course, an Imaginite chest. We got a rare item. Ooh, Smasher. Well, that's interesting. A clobber gobble. It's a chicken leg or a turkey leg. Big one. All right. Notice there's another experience ball over there. I think that's the third one on this level. It's not hard to get to. Just gotta jump up here and grab it. Now you will sacrifice when you get that, the ability of this platform here. It went back up, so you gotta come all the way back down. These are on a timing mechanism, so you have to make the jumps quick or else you don't get to do it. All right, to the bridge.
Okay, Skylander, you get to the main panel up there and regain control of the ship. Me, I'll be down in the galley, taking back what's mine.
All right, so this is a Doomlander battle, so I'll be switching now from my Airstrike Sensei to my undead Imaginator.
Don't mess with me.
Davy Bones, as he's called in the Connors game. They don't carry the name over. I have to like rename him again if I want to keep the name, which is kind of weird. Apparently, because he was created in Connors game, he stays, his name stays in that game. It's kind of weird.
Okay, Sky Losers. I don't know what you fools are trying to accomplish by taking back this stupid battleship. But in any case, I summon the Purple Doomlander Knight of Cataclysm! Thought I was going to say Doom, didn't you?
Doomlander, Knight Class.
Party with my wrath!
Eh?
All right, so Knight... Doomlander.
Not an Imaginator! They're so strong against my
and I use my swashbuckler
everybody.
Imaginator. I like using my spinning attack here. But I also have this spit. That if I spit in his face, kind of does damage over time, which is nice. So I use my Y attack to spin out of the way of his blade. And it's kind of cool if I get him over here, spin away. Oh, it didn't happen. There, he hits the edge. Then you can beat him up. So trick him into coming toward the edge. And then when he hits it, you can deal some extra damage while he tries to get up.
Extremely angry at you, Skylamos, for busting up my Doomlander. I'm not, because this time I've got a little trick up my sleeve.
I don't think that trick works anymore because he doesn't take multiple swipes at you right now on this phase.
You knocked off some of its gear.
To get really annoyed here, but hey, this is me, the new Chaos, being a lot more chill about everything. and cranking this Doom Loser's muscles up to 11!
You know what would make now, you definitely don't want to get in the way of this wrecking ball. And if you can get him in the way of the wrecking ball, all the better. He just took 500 damage. So, there's the path. I missed it. Walked through the path again. Hopefully, there. Hit him. He's stunned. He's gonna attack. There we go. Got him before the wrecking ball came through to do the job.
Level up. I'm not going to lie here. That sucked. But this Doom Flounder was merely an appetizer. Something to distract you while the main course continues to destroy your precious Skylands. Good luck dealing with that.
All right, so let's get our Imaginite chest. Now my reward is not the Doomlander parts anymore because I already have them.
New headgear.
Ooh, got an extra hat.
New head.
Monkey head.
New head.
And ninja head. So, three real boring pieces there, but that's okay. Gotta collect them all.
Well, Skylander, we did it. While my lunch still remains at large, the battleship is under our control again. And I think it's ready to take on Chaos's latest monstrosity. Let us set sail for this beast! Tally-ho!
Alright, so that's the end of the level. We got all of our storyline items, got all of our collections, and all the dares except for that speed run, which can't do that when you're also getting everything else. But that is probably not. It's not hard if you have the right Skylander. Now, I'm going to go ahead and fight the Guacamole Monster.
According to the battleship's guacamole detecting radar, we've tracked that guacamole monster here to this strange island. Wonder what kind of unspeakable acts he could be up to.
God, it's a salsa island!
Sure, I don't have to tell you about the awesome power of combining salsa and guacamole. We need to stop this guy, and fast!
Alright. So if you quit the game now, you'd have to go back to that spot I showed you before to get back on the battleship. But we'll just go ahead and do it now, and I'll take out the Guacamole Monster. There's really no secrets about this level, but I guess there is some strategy.
Okay, Skylander. You're gonna need to steer this battleship around and blast that guacamole monster with our cannons.
So there he is. He's gonna throw stuff at us. He can move away left and right. You can turn around with the A button. Notice how there's three lines when I turn around. You can see there's a top, a middle, and a bottom. That's basically the three different paths you can fly. Top, middle, bottom. Wherever you are, you can move and dodge by going just up and down. You can also dodge by throwing. Left and right, but it's a little harder. So then just keep firing on him and dodging at the same time. If you need to turn around, you just fly and turn around. You can dodge up, you can dodge down. If he goes up, then you have to go up to shoot at that level.
Watch out, Skylander! Excellent! We are well on our way to victory!
If you shoot the... can't shoot it because he's grabbed it, but if you shoot that thing while it's before it gets into his hands, it can explode and give a little bonus damage. You can also blow up parts of the level, but I've not found that doing that really buys you anything. It doesn't do any extra damage or unlock anything.
Hmm.
If you blow it up there.
A big explosion that may damage the guacamole monster if he's near.
Right. If you blow it up before he picks it up, it'll explode. Alright, so we beat him. But we didn't.
Ha! Not so tough now, are you, Quacky? Wait a minute. That other guacamole monster was merely an appetizer. There's the main course! I definitely don't need to tell you that this is bad, Skylander. But, as usual, I have a cunning plan. Take out the tentacles to defeat Guacamole Monster 2.0.
Alright, so now ignore the guacamole monster you saw before.
Now is the time to blast his guac arms.
And instead, attack the arms. Nope. Disappear and come back in these different holes.
I say, he's an angry guacamole monster.
In whatever level the arm is on, you want to dodge by going to a different level. Oh, and here's a power up. That's going to make it a little more damaging there. Well, look at that damage. Did we get it? I almost got the first arm. It doesn't last very long, but it's very helpful to have all that extra damage power. Alright, there's one arm down. You still have to dodge the smaller guacamole monsters. Whoops, I missed that one. Thought I already went.
Mega cannon.
Alright, there's the cannon.
Don't like that, do you, Guacky?
Stay higher than the arm and then attack.
Hit the arm, Skylander. The arm.
He's way over there. He's going low. So first I stay higher and then I fire my rockets at him.
I say, he's an angry guacamole monster, isn't he?
It definitely helps to have that power up, but I did not get it, or was not able to use it for long. But we almost have him. There we go. That was phase two, but with most bosses, there are three phases.
Gas! There it is! The head!
Alright, so to attack the head, you gotta be at the top. Now you gotta ignore arms and what the head throws at you, and the little guacamoles, which will throw you all that same stuff at you. So there's an arm, you want to be above that. Now if we keep driving around, we're going to find, there we go, a ship repair item. Or, I think on the other side is the bonus damage. So let's go ahead and grab the bonus damage. See if we can't take him out a little faster. There it is.
Mega cannon.
Mega cannon. Am I hitting him? There I am. Whoops. I had to dodge. Not the best area to shoot the mega cannon at him because he's behind a lot of stuff.
Watch out, Skylander!
Get a good few seconds in before you start throwing more guacamole balls at you.
Guacamole monstrosity. Incoming!
Pretty safe right here, that's a little slow. Almost got him. Oh.
We've been hit!
We were hit, but we stayed in there long enough to get him. So there we go. Alright.
I must say, as hungry as I still am, I shan't be eating guacamole for quite some time. Certainly happy to see another one of Chaos's beasties go down, though. In fact, I hope historians one day write about our momentous victory over the guacamole monster. But for now, let us head back to the M.A.P.
powerful brain in the known universe.
Who said that?
Who else? There's only one smartest, most powerful brain in the known universe last time I checked. And believe me,
I check a lot. Brain? Is that you?
Ta-da! That's right. I'm in your bird now. I noticed that his mind was quite easy to infiltrate. But getting a hang of this depth perception thing is a different story.
Yes, well, speaking of short-sightedness, brain, those stupid Skylanders defeated my supposedly ultimate Doomlander. Hope you're happy.
Look, pal, it's not my fault you thought about guacamole during the all-important creation process. But hey, if you want something else, no problem. You just need to be more specific.
Fine. How about this for specific? My Doomlanders are utterly feeble! What they need to be is awesomely fearsome! Like some sort of awesomely fierce beast thing! Get me, brain?
Yeah, you're not giving me a lot to go on, but I've got just the thing. Presto, brain-o!
Ah! Ow.
Are you all right, Lord Chaos?
I'm fine. There's been a change of plans. We're going to the soda factory. It's time to unleash the beast!
Cuckoo!
Yes, indeed. That'll be the last time a giant monster made entirely of guacamole messes with us.
To be honest, I still can't believe there was even a first time.
Guess what? Fizzland is under attack!
Fizzland? Is that really a thing?
Yeah. It's where all my magic potions get made. We also have a farmer's market there every Sunday. Although, I probably wouldn't recommend it.
Okay, Skylander. You might want to go with Pop Fizz and check this out. We'll try to figure out what Chaos is up to next.
All right, well, that's going to wrap it up then. That was the Sky Fortress and the guacamole battle. Not too bad. It can be a little tricky finding some of those things, so hopefully I helped you find something on that level. If you've been struggling with the guacamole monster, hopefully I showed you something that you already didn't know maybe, but that one seems pretty straightforward too. You could die a couple times. You just keep trying and eventually figure out his pattern, the arm patterns and that kind of stuff. So that's going to wrap it up for today. If you liked it, please hit the like button. We'll be back again soon with another video. I think my next walkthrough is going to be some more Sensei Shrines. So until then, have fun playing Skylanders, and I'll see you soon.